Hey, it's Anthony from TBN here. Now, since Shadow Man Remastered is being released on PC and all major consoles later this year, let's take a look at how the original game on Nintendo 64 and the newly released PC version compare visually, as well as run through the remaster's additional content and find out whether this game's worth picking up. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe, as we publish reviews on the latest games each and every week. Now onto the show. Okay, first things first, this game is weird, and not in the Silent Hill 2 weird but good kind of way, if you know what I mean. The moment Shadow Man begins with its dramatic scenes of an impending apocalypse, it's straight up obvious that there's a collective ton of jank around the corner. In regards to the story and characters, Shadow Man tries to come across as serious and brooding like a Linkin Park music video, although just ends up sounding very angsty and kind of cringe at the same time. The off-kilter writing and B-movie level voice acting not helping its cause.
Okay, so let me get this straight. If I don't recover these dark souls...
I say, hold up, wait a minute, something ain't right.
When you break down the gameplay department, it's not much more exciting either. The main protagonist, Michael, has these awkward, tank-like controls, which also slow him down when moving backwards for some reason. Like trying to pull an elephant along on a string. And the jumping mechanics for the platforming sections just don't feel good, full stop. The remaster does spruce up the controls a little bit, however, it's only a touch better. Still can't change direction mid-air though. Kinda grinds my gears a bit, not gonna lie. Once you combine all that baggage with Shadow Man's repetitive, lackluster gameplay, you've got yourself the perfect recipe for buyer's remorse. Because, let's be real, most of the fights can be narrowed down to shooting undead enemies from afar, or strafing from side to side while you just simply wait for an enemy's health to drain towards zero. In other words, it's not that appealing. There's only so many times a player can run around in a circle and shoot an entire round's worth of bullets into an enemy, then repeat the same type of encounter over and over again without it getting old sooner or later. And while there are a couple different weapons to be found throughout the journey, it doesn't take long for the formula to dampen the overall experience. Also, why can't Michael move and shoot when aiming manually? It's been 20 years. The devs included a weapon wheel, but they still can't make the main character move in first person? Come on! That all being said, the level designs and platformer sections are surprisingly well made. Pity the controls don't stack up, although the variety of different obstacles and challenges that Michael has to overcome can be quite engaging at times, ranging from walking on narrow beams to solving treacherous puzzle areas or overcoming some tight jumping sections when the controls actually want to work in your favor, so a few thumbs up there. The graphical presentation is also pretty decent for a remaster. Looking back at the original release on Nintendo 64, not the PS1 version, that was awful, Shadow Man's spooky atmosphere definitely had its own charm and really sold that hardcore, dark and gritty horror film aesthetic, especially in the game's lighting and textures. And now with the remastered edition, Night Dive Studios are cranking up its graphical elements with 4K widescreen and HDR support, enhanced textures, per pixel lighting, a field of view slider, ambient occlusion, and other post-processing effects. What's also really cool for fans of the 1999 release is that all the cut content from the original developers, Acclaim, is being restored, and in some cases, being completely made from the ground up by Night Dive Studios. Their original creations being based on leftover in-game assets and design documents from Acclaim. Some of the new features include more bosses, enemies, and levels, as well as a remastered soundtrack and sound effects, a handful of tweaks to enemy behavior, physics, and a bunch of modern improvements all around that would be way too long to list here. A lot of neat stuff for fans of the original, I must say. At the end of the day, Shadow Man is a tough sell for newcomers, because other action platformers have refined this genre to a T. Veterans will most likely be happy with all the new additions, but even then, it still falls flat in a few key aspects. The gunplay is as simplistic as it gets, the movement controls are super jank for modern standards, and the story's presentation is the equivalent of watching a direct-to-DVD horror movie. Well, I guess that's one redeeming quality, eh? Guys, if you enjoyed this vid, give us a thumbs up, and be sure to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon next to it so you won't miss an upload. This really helps our channel grow too. For more horror-themed content, check out my review of Catherine, Full Body, or visit thebetanetwork.net to read my full, written review on Shadow Man Remastered.